Hi guys, today we are going to see task-oriented approach to guide visually impaired people during smart device usage. So this one is our abstract. So we are going to help our visually impaired persons to allocate a task based, so that will help to guide during their using smart devices. So here existing studies have reported a lack of step-by-step guidance for visually impaired users to perform tasks on smart devices. Although prototype on non-visible interface systems were implemented to aid blind people in using mobile phones, and also to address these limitations, we propose a novel guidance system that employs an object detection method for recognizing the control panels of smart devices and offers appropriate guidelines based on the user's targeted task. So a user study conducted with 20 participants indicated that users were more satisfied with our guidance system than with existing voice assistants. So our main objective is a camera-based assistive text reading framework to help blind persons to read text labels and product packaging from handheld objects in their daily lives. So the project should be portable to assist the blind persons. The entire application is based on Raspberry Pi. So this one is our introduction slide. So as the result, they found some critical usability problems, one of which is the lack of interactive and step-by-step guidance for the users to correctly access the necessary features to accomplish their task in existing systems. So existing systems have also been attempts to develop prototype systems for real-time object detection using a deep neural network machine learning model. And also here, have been some studies on enabling visually impaired users to navigate websites on mobile with suggestion based systems that employs a non-visual interface. The approaches work only on predefined mobile phone applications or only website navigation. So disadvantages: it's a less economical, it's time consuming process since text localization itself takes much more time. So proposed system we are using as a neural network, convolutional neural network. And also it tracks the location of the user's fingertip in relation to icons or buttons on devices correctly and quickly. So here possible to recognize icons or buttons while tracing the location of the user's fingertip on a screen or on the control panel of any device. So here SSD based on deep neural network approach that fundamentally employs a CNN. That means convolutional neural network. The guidelines for operating devices can be created and it will help you to use the smart devices by visually impaired persons. So advantages: less power consumption, audio output, efficient for blind people. This enables us to confirm the accurate position and exact time required to touch the button from the smart devices. So however, this model is not effective on devices with small screens such as mobile devices. So software requirements: we need Python programming IDLE and then Raspbian OS. Hardware requirements: we need Raspberry Pi 3B+. So in this proposed system, we are using a 3B+ model. We can improve our system performance by using Raspberry Pi 4 and then 4B. Some advanced versions, we can get a much more speed processor. So Pi camera, power supply, SD card, audio output unit. Block diagram: Pi camera capture the object or any trained images or objects. It will send into Raspberry Pi. It will predict by using our SSD, CNN neural network, and then it will recognize to guide the visually impaired person through to our audio output. This one is workflow. So image acquisition, it will be converted into RGB to gray image, and then after it will we fix the thresholding. After it will we detect the images edges, and then automatically it will be text will be extracted, and then we are using an OCR concept. Then it will identify the text, and then finally audio output will be we get. This one is our algorithm. So button and fingertip identification procedure. So here input is the two object variables for the button and fingertip bounding box coordinates. Button and finger, which include x my minimum, x maximum, y minimum and y maximum as attributes of the object for the bounding boxes. So here bounding boxes based, we can predict our correct location of fingertip from the smart devices. So working, this is a working model. So here a machine learning platform used in this work, SSD mobile net version 2 So TensorFlow provides the SSG mobile net version to neural network model for training as an application programming interface. This means API. So this is a tool for applying the configured model SSG mobile net version 2 to the guidance system. So here I used speech to text feature and also speech to text Android Studio. It enables users to talk to the guidance system, and the text that is generated by this component is processed by the system to recognize the user's intention by camera. So here external workflow is divided into external entities and then internal entities. So here a user who interacts with the guidance system, smartphone, the guidance system runs on the user's smartphone. Camera will capture user's fingertip and the user interface of the target device. The camera can be installed on the user's personal device such as a smart glasses, that means a target device. The device that is the user wants to operate, this device shows the user interface and is operated by touching icons or buttons. So specifying target button with voice input. So user talks to the guidance system regarding the feature to be activated, and then locate button and fingertip. The guidance system detects icons or buttons from the smart device on the user interface of the device and the fingertip of the user by using machine learning model. So here guidance feedback and then fingertip movement can be monitored, like it means fingertip to the location instructed by the guidance system. So result feedback, the guidance system finally gives the confirmation feedback regarding the correct position from the visually impaired person fingertip to the smart device button or any icon. This one is workflow. So here voice input to activate the system, and then button and finger detection can be detected. Button and also our fingertip also captured, that means boundary boxes. After guidance will be played, that means the feedback, and then finger movement. So depending upon our finger movement, we can touch the exact buttons, and it will be say the reply message as the okay. So this is user smartphone. So we are going to activate the target device, such means a treadmill. So here treadmill buttons we can recognize by using our Raspberry Pi system. So here Raspberry Pi hardware requirements, we need a Raspberry Pi 3B plus, that's a Pi camera. So audio output unit, so it will only give the guidance system through to our audio message. So Raspbian OS PuTTY, we can connect our Raspberry Pi to system laptop, means we need a PuTTY configuration, and also we can control our Raspberry Pi through remotely by using VNC viewer. So Python programming we are making here our concept using our Python programming language. So applications, goods acceptance, goods delivery, shipping. So where we control our smart devices by the visually impaired persons, so those system having our proposed system. So feature scope, we can add much more images of vehicles to identify the blind people to choose the transportation, and also adding obstacle avoidance system to ensure the safety of blind person. So this one is our conclusion. The time delay is the response, thereby affecting the performance of the system. So here by learning approaches such as a faster CNN are not applicable to the mobile phones. By implementing our guidance system on smart glasses and adopting more advanced machine learning models, the system can guide visually impaired people to operate smart devices faster and more accurately, to activate the buttons or to touch the buttons. This one is a reference line. That's all. Thank you.